Hi, welcome to This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup, I'm editor Magicbricks, and I have with me Prabhakar Sinha, real estate editor of the Times of India. And there are lots of things that have gone right in the country since RERA has come. But there are a couple of issues that consumers have raised to us, and we thought we should pick it up. If the RERA authority passes an order in your favor, how many of those are actually getting implemented? And Prabhakar, this is a big issue for many consumers. You go to RERA, you get, in the beginning, most RERAs were giving refund orders. But there was not money in the system and the refunds were not happening. There are RERAs which have asked the developer to do certain things, but in the beginning, that has not happened. Has that changed at all? And this is a good time to take stock of how effective are RERA orders.
Now, particularly on the refund side, now in some cases, the RERA have earlier, basically, when the entire thing had started, RERA used to give order of refunds and asking developer to refund the money with interest to the buyers. But later on, when the realization came that this is not feasible, and as the prices have fallen of real estate, many of the buyers thought that it is better to take money back with interest rather than take delivery of the house. So later on, what RERA said that if a developer completed 70% and around that, the entire projects, they said that they resisted from giving, this is the giving order for the refund. But for certain orders still, now where the project has not been made, say over 50% or 60%, or the buyers are in the dire need of money, RERA has given or it is still giving order of refund. In one or two cases I have seen in Gurgaon particularly, they have given that entire order, and if the developer has not paid the money to the buyers, then RERA has get the order implemented through collector, and they have asked the collector for the CURC.
Which state would this be?
I don't remember the case, but this is in Haryana, in Gurgaon RERA, they did it. And then entire procedure was on because the CURC order is not getting implemented so easily in this country. Another thing is this, that then I was talking to some of the authority head, and they are saying it that what we want, that the situation should be resolved, and this can be resolved only if the project is completed. So later on, they are not giving that kind of order of refund, but they are saying that you should remain in the project and let the project get completed, and then after, once the delivery happens, then after we will ask the developer to pay the damage or the penalty for the delay and all
so
that.
So the first thing that we can actually tell consumers is that if the RERA had passed an order in your favor saying that you should get a refund, and today the developer is not giving the refund, that is probably because there has been a rethink in the entire, at the court level, at the NCDRC level, at the RERA level, and at the government and developer level, that first let's complete the stuck project. Because if the if 10 consumers withdraw their money from the project, whatever hope there is of getting those projects complete, even that goes away, and therefore it's only a deferred order, right?
Yeah.
Once the project is complete, and once the last unit in that project has got the completion certificate, that's the time when you can restart that process of taking your order, saying I was given a refund, I want my refund. And that's the thinking across markets, that let's complete the projects that are stuck because of the large volume of incomplete projects that are there in the market.
Yeah,
please go
on. Or otherwise, if suppose if a developer is not implementing the RERA order, then RERA can file a case against him in the and he can be jailed also, and can order to jail him, say up to 6 months or certain period of time, it is given in the act itself. But so far I have not come across any such order, particularly in this area, Delhi or NCR Delhi side, but I believe that in some other courts have given this kind of a order also. In that situation, developer has the right to go on appeal at the higher court. And once you have gone into that circle, then it is again a time consuming
Because it's gone into the civil court, and
it will take its own time. So it is better, I believe, and now it is also in favor of developer, and developer also want today.
Yeah.
that to complete the project or to resolve the issues with RERA of all the buyers. If that doesn't happen today, then there is another huge risk is lurking over these developers. Buyers can go to NCLT claiming their money, and in that case, developer is completely out of the project.
Because the NCLT can now give the order instantly, right?
Instantly.
The, liquidation order instantly.
No, no. First of all, the developer will be out and they will go for the resolution within 270 days. In that resolution, the developer can't participate. So, the developer will be completely out of the system, and with that, the NCLT can also order the audit, the forensic audit, and the developer can caught very badly in a bad situation. So, developers are now avoiding, they are trying to avoid that situation. So, many developers you talk and they will say that they want to work with RERA to resolve the issues of the buyers amicably, so that the buyers and the developers both survive, and plus the resolution can happen fast in RERA, because if they, both of them want to work. In NCLT, what happens once the developer is out, only the system remains, and then the new body will come and they will take over the project and they would like to implement
the
project.
And they have 270 days to take
the resolution level and all that. So, it is again time consuming and it may take time. But that is also one tool available with the buyers. And the developers are now understanding this very fact, and because of that, now they are thinking that was it is better to work with RERA to complete or resolve the entire issues of the buyers. So, it is with the buyers now. So, I don't think that developers can afford it, and besides that, RERA has teeth, but RERA doesn't have adequate teeth.
In fact, I'd like to at this point tell you what one of the RERA authorities, regulators, the Madhya Pradesh regulator, a state where RERA is extremely well run, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh were ready with their websites on day one. They have been implementing very well. But in a RERA analysis forum that the ministry had conducted, this is what the Madhya Pradesh RERA regulator had to say. He says that it should have the power to issue directives to other stakeholders besides allottees and builders, such as government agencies and local departments. This is agreed by all RERA regulators, that if the approval authorities don't come under their purview, what happens is that there can be delays at that level. And there have been. In fact, in one case, one of the Maharashtra RERA regulators, even though officially they are not reporting to them, the Maharashtra RERA figured that the developer had completed the project. The consumers have paid, the developer has completed, but the completion certificate and the occupancy certificate was taking far too much time. So, they sent a note to the approval authorities to ask why this delay happened. When the authorities came in the next hearing,
they came
with the approval order saying that everything is ready, here's the occupancy certificate. Sometimes it is the legal process in the authorities that delays it, and therefore it's much better that they should also report in. Now, one more thing that that Mr. Anthony Deesa of Madhya Pradesh RERA has said. He says that RERA should be given the powers of a civil court to implement its decisions. Otherwise, it will be dependent on the civil courts, and the time taken to implement the order will take far too long. This is the crux of the issue. When a RERA court issues an order, does it have the power to implement its own order?
Now, it doesn't have direct power. Basically, it can direct the developer to perform certain kind of a duty or certain act. Now, if it doesn't do, then RERA can file an FIR and can send him to jail.
Right.
But for that, again, he is dependent on the civil court, either district collector or district magistrate. Finally, they have to sentence him and they'll have
RERA has the right to put penalties on the developer. For instance, if the developer was told that you have to start the project immediately and the project does not start, the penalties are very hefty, and the RERA court can order the penalties. That normally what we've seen is you don't have to take the penalty from the developer. The threat of penalty itself has brought developers into line. And I think at this point, instead of saying let's hammer the developer, let's hammer the system, what everybody is trying is, can we go through the conciliatory process, where the RERA has to act tough, it is acting tough. Where the RERA has to allow certain things to be. For instance, if they've given an order that 10 investors should get their money back. Those were early days of RERA, and the true picture of the market did not come through. But today, what they are saying is, it can become a deferred order. It's not that they're taking that away from you, but they're saying that if you want your money back, that will come only after the project is complete, because that is in the interest of the economy, and that's in the interest of the larger number of buyers. But Prabhakar, one more thing I want
In this case also, particularly the government officials, particularly say Noida also or Haryana also, in both these places, the many of the projects could not be completed, could not get the completion certificate because of certain shortcomings from the government side.
Right.
And RERA cannot ask the government authority to complete those obligations,
right,
like say the water connection or like the electricity connection in entire Haryana, but Gurgaon, say in Dwarka Expressway and all these areas. Despite the fact that the project is completed, entire payment has been made to the government, but the government is not doing that. In Noida side itself, you see that the government has conceded to this fact that there is a zero period time where the construction was not allowed at the behest of the court order because of the court order. But for that period, authority has charged interest and penal rates from the buyers.
Absolutely.
The developers.
Yeah.
Now, RERA says that because of this period has to be declared zero period, so the authority or the government body must declare it. But for that, ultimately, it is the administration, the UP government administration
has
to do
it. And that order still hasn't come through.
And the RERA cannot direct them.
Absolutely.
RERA can only request them.
Yeah.
And now, because of that, this entire process has been delayed by at least more than 6 months so far.
And here, it's not the RERA, it's not the fact that a RERA order was not implemented. It is that the solution lies in another government department.
Exactly.
And that is the approvals authority.
And RERA, basically today the problem is of the resolution of the various issues, yes, which because of which the project is not completed. And those resolution will come when all the stakeholders will come at the same table or the same level and to complete that entire thing. That is the one part.
Mm-hmm.
Another what you are saying is right, that ultimately RERA can't say that okay, because there is no police standing in the court who will take that guilty person behind the bar. So he'll have to ultimately depend on the civil courts to get the final order executed to send him behind bar, and that is the biggest threat or biggest kind of a fear a developer has. At the same time, the developer, even today, even after that, you know, now developer has that power or has the right to go to the higher court on appeal. So now ultimately that it is the appeal, and you cannot stop somebody from appealing that entire thing. So the RERA...
Prabhakar, let's pick up other regulators. We have TRAI, we have SEBI, we have IRDA. When they pass an order, what is the does any other civil court have jurisdiction over its order?
In TRAI and all that, the penal provision is huge.
Yeah.
And if they cancel the license, the repercussion is huge.
Yeah.
So that is sufficient enough from the for a company not to go haywire, and they'll have to follow the TRAI order. Similarly, the RBI thing. Now, when the RBI is regulating a bank, the financial stake is so huge that the bankers cannot think of doing anything hanky-panky, because they know it that if RBI wants, they can cancel the license even. And the cancellation of the license is a huge, huge risk.
And here actually, the reason why we picked that up is, RERA is a new regulator. The issue is extremely complex, as was the issue when SEBI was created. It was a huge issue. The thing is that it did take a couple of years to resolve. But here, the amount of money invested in housing by average everyday persons, not as investment, but as purchasing a commodity that they need for personal use. And therefore, the volume, and we allowed this problem to fester for a very long time. Also, the thing is that there are many, many individual buyers who have now got a secured creditor status. If you want the best out of RERA, if you want the, today everyone is willing to work with RERA. We believe that even the developers and a lot of the market has been sorting itself out. The non-serious players are selling out to the serious players, and we can see that out of the number of developers who were in the market, there was no entry barrier, anybody could be a developer. Today, the number of developers are shrinking. We can see that serious players are remaining in the market. But like every other regulator, this regulator also needs a little more time to sort the market out, and there are many, many stakeholders.
Particularly RERA also. I'll just say one thing here, that in RERA also, if RERA finds that this developer is not following their order or is not working towards resolution of the issues, then RERA can put him aside and RERA can say that I'm taking over this project and I'm appointing somebody else to complete the projects or to monitor the projects, and they can do it separately also.
So is there a time frame in which RERA can do that? Is there a cooling period?
No, if RERA finds that the developer is not working towards resolution, and if it is convinced, it can put out the developer on day one itself.
Right.
So that's not an issue. But only thing is this, that will that help in resolution of the issue?
Yeah.
That is the main problem. And that is why they want to work with the existing developer, first of all, to give them a time also, and thinking that that might expedite the whole process of resolution of the entire project.
In fact, the UP RERA regulator said that they are also allowing the system of co-development, so that if the developer can't do it himself, but there is still money in the project, there is cash flow, it is cash flow positive, they will allow a co-developer to come in and complete the project. In many cases, even without a RERA intervention, many developers are actually doing this. If they have any other, if the cash flows in the project are positive, there are other developers, both CREDA and NARADCO have told us that they are willing to step in with their own members and try and take projects to completion. The limited point is that there is an issue there. Does RERA have total rights of implementation? Maybe
no,
not.
No.
But is that holding the system back, Prabhakar? What do you think?
Certainly not. At present, not, because the RERA has just started its work, so it has not come to a level where they think that, okay, now there is no other way and they have to go to the civil court to file a case against that developer or things like that.
That's
they have
to
depend on that.
That's few and far between,
yeah.
Right?
So, right now that is not the situation. Right now, in fact, developer is also working towards resolution, towards the completion of the project in the monitoring of the RERA itself, and the RERA is appointing their own consultants in the project,
sure.
And they are seeing that project is completed. So, right now this is in that state. But on the issue of refund, there is a,
yes.
Huge tug of war, because developers are saying that there are not enough money left in the system, and so the refund with interest is not possible, and if the refund is going out, then certainly the project cannot be completed. And now both the RERA, in fact Haryana and the UP and other RERA also, other state RERA also are saying it, that if the project or the developer is ready to complete the project, right now they are not going overboard in giving order in favor of refund.
Sure.
They are saying that first of all, let the project be complete.
And so that's why Magicbricks is running a campaign, hashtag complete stuck projects. Let's get the project through so that all consumers can get it. One more issue before we go into the thing, which I would like you to comment on. Most RERA regulators have spoken to us saying that come as a body of buyers rather than an individual buyer.
Yeah.
Just help the consumers understand why that is so important.
Particularly in the case of a resolution for the completion of a project. Now, if one individual buyer goes and asks the refund, this RERA will say that no, it is not possible because the project is 70% complete, because the RERA first of all will call developer to ask them that what is the problem. If the developer says that they want to complete the project, then certainly RERA will say that okay, you do it first. Now, if you want to expedite the completion, and if you think that the developer is not working towards completion of the project and they are not constructing, so it is better that you go as an association, because RERA nowadays, what do? That they appoint the president or secretary of the association as a signatory authority in the escrow account,
right,
in which all the money, whatever the buyers are paying, goes, and that money is used only for the construction of the project, 100% money, and the developer cannot take out any money from that.
So So that gives you the right to actually monitor whether your money is going into the property.
And that entire escrow account is also monitored by one of the consultant appointed by the RERA, under whose supervision that construction work is going on. Now, in fact, RERA says that if buyers are not satisfied with the development or the cooperation of the developers, then RERA, the buyers association, can think of appointing a new contractor also to complete the project.
And RERA is supporting you.
And RERA is supporting you. And in that case, but that doesn't mean that developer will go completely scot-free. Now the developer, the RERA will also start a prosecution against that developer, so that the money that he has taken out should come back into the system. But that will be a separate leg.
And we can see that there are financial audits of companies going on, the ones that have gone to NCLT. There are other cases where ultimately everyone knows that there was money in the system, right? And the money has been siphoned out of the system. And wherever that money trail is can be chased, it is being chased. But do you want to wait till that entire money trail is chased and brought back?
It might take 3 years.
It might take 3 years. And that's why we are saying, if you can afford to get another developer, get into the driver's seat and ensure that your project is complete. Remember that your incomplete project or your stressed asset is 30 to 50% less in value than a completed asset. So, even while you're fighting for justice, make sure that work is on the ground, that cranes are moving, that work, that your project is going through. Let's pick up some of the queries that have started coming in. We've got Karan Reddy from Hyderabad, who says he filed a complaint with RERA for delay in possession and the authority also awarded the compensation. But how do I get it implemented in the builder's office if he further delays paying off the compensation?
Go to RERA.
Go back to RERA and tell them. But we are again telling you that the compensation is the last issue that RERA is going to address.
Yeah.
Completion is going to be the first priority.
Yeah.
There's Arun Singh of Pune who says many home buyers are miffed with the delay in the execution of MAHARERA orders, particularly related to refund recovery from developers in their favor. Why orders remain only on paper? But Prabhakar, explain once
more. Now, issue is this, that here in this case, if they are not implementing that order, you go back to the RERA. RERA will again call the developer and ask them that you must repay him in certain such and such date, and still he fails, then RERA can order a court order to seize their entire property. Now, to implement that order, RERA has to go to the district collector.
Yes.
Now, the entire paper will go to district collector, and district collector will start the entire exercise of seizing the property. Now, this way might take time. Now, whether RERA will go to that extent, that has to be seen, that what kind of problem is, if that developer suppose is implementing that project also, and if this kind of order is passed to coup that entire property, in that case, that implementation of the project will get hold over. So, that will create another problem. So, now I don't know what stage at your order is and in what condition that order has been given.
But go back to RERA.
And
put your problem back to RERA. RERA authorities are listening to you. They are explaining to you. Instead of getting agitated that your order was not implemented, go back to RERA and ask them, why is my order not implemented yet and when do I expect it to be implemented? RERA authorities are very, very conciliatory. They are also very, they appreciate your problems, and the consumers are being, queries are being addressed very effectively.
Yeah, and RERA can be very harsh to the developer also.
Yes.
So, I mean, and for that matter, I am telling you that developer are really very, very fearful of RERA, and they normally implement that order very meekly.
We would like to tell you that Gitambar Anand, who leads, who is the chairman of CREDAI, has actually spoken to us about this year, prospects of the year, how RERA is going to impact the market, and also what consumers should do, how they can work with developers in a mood of conciliation. We urge our consumers to come back to MBTV and watch this video as well. It will be available for viewing from late tonight. Let me go back to Daniel David of Bangalore, who says, I booked a flat from a builder based in Bangalore. It was a 2 BHK flat. I recently got possession and a few things are still not up to the mark in my unit. Shall I go to RERA? I got to know that RERA judgments are not being implemented on time. Please suggest. That's not true.
No, that's not true. That's not true.
When, if there is a deficiency of service, this is something that RERA is implementing, going hammer and tongs implementing across the country. If you've got a defective flat, there is a 5-year zero defect liability period which RERA has to enforce on the developer if there are things that are not up to the mark. Remember, there are two kinds of things. One is services and one is the quality of workmanship. Both are covered in the RERA and the developer has to set it right. Please go back to RERA and get it implemented. These orders are being implemented. There is Gautam Sarandas who says, builders are making money used for other personal property and other projects in Hyderabad.
That is everywhere for that matter. I am not saying that the builders are not making money. And I believe
they are justifiably making money, and that should not be the grudge also. Your grudge, Your grudge has to be if what is promised to you is not delivered.
Not delivered.
If a developer declared that he is going to sell a property at say 4,200 rupees per square foot, he has made his own computations and arrived at the price. Now, if you like the price, you pick it up. There is no compulsion. But if you've picked up at 4,200 and it was supposed to be completed in say 2 years or 3 years and the developer has not completed it, that's when you have a grouse and go back to RERA. Here, whatever is in your builder-buyer agreement, that is what RERA is able to enforce, and that is for how the orders are being.
And you should be concerned about the mainly thing.
You should be concerned about that.
Yeah.
There is Manish Mathur of Faridabad who bought a 2 BHK flat in Faridabad and the builder had a few issues in the lift of 1 and 2 towers. We filed a RERA complaint and it was in our favour as well. However, the builder has made us wait for 4 months to get this done. We had to wait too long. What should we do in such cases? I think these things do take time. Even when a RERA order comes, if the builder did not address it, you can have a grouse.
Yeah.
If the builder is addressing it and in 4 months he has rectified the problem with the lift, any structural issue can take up to 6 months to a year. Because remember that it is somewhere deep inside the building and you have to set that right. And you can't do a cosmetic job. These are serious issues and these have to be set right at the basic level. So, it will take a little time. Be patient. If the RERA has addressed your issue and the builder is addressing that, you should be happy. There is Mohit Arora of Chandigarh who says, do you think builders use delay tactics in order to make buyers wait for things they have got in their favor through RERA judgments? Maybe in the beginning, yes, there was a period where developers were
of the opinion that they might get a favorable judgment, but that is not happening.
That is not happening, and today it's very clear that whether it is the Supreme Court, the High Court, the NCLT or the RERA, it is the consumer who's king. It is the consumer's interests that are being protected. So please don't feel that they are being biased against you. Today they are biased, but they are biased in your favor, not in favor of the developers. There is Chandan Kumar of Noida who says, my flat is still not registered with the authority, but possession has been obtained. I have noticed a few things which are not delivered by the builder. If I go to RERA, will those be offered by the developer? Please suggest.
Obviously. You must go to RERA and see that and see clearly that the project has not been completed as it was promised. And this is so the before completion certificate is issued to them, they must complete it. In fact, you should also go to the authority and tell the authority that these deficiencies are there in the project and ask the developer to complete the project in toto before issuing them the completion certificate. And I am telling you that the authority, in fact, before giving them completion certificate in Noida, Greater Noida, they advertise. And they in the advertise, they invite all the stakeholders to suggest that what are shortcomings left in the project, and unless you are satisfied, the developer cannot get and will not get the completion certificate. So you just go and file a complaint to the authority. That is the best thing. Otherwise, wait. Authority has to advertise in the newspaper that on such and such date, before such and such date, you must file a complaint, or you must file saying that you are not satisfied with the construction or with the certain provisions given in that project. so that the completion certificate is only after resolution of those problems, completion certificate will be given to the developer. So you must become, or before that you can go to the authority complaining this.
There is Deepak Shah who's complaining against the Gujarat RERA. He says, Gujarat is not giving judgment on my complaint, which is 1 year old. The decision is kept reserved on 16-10-18, but even after lodged grievance to PMO before, I think, some date, no decision has been given by RERA.
Better RERA will ask. Tell you.
You have to go back to your RERA authority, and actually we don't have enough to comment on your case. But there must be a reason that the RERA authority has given you why it has reserved the judgment. Maybe that project, there are 2-3 reasons why this could happen. The project may not be cash flow positive. The developer has got all the money in hand, and but he has not shown the money in the project, and there are not enough units to be sold, or there's not enough land to be monetized, and therefore the project is not cash flow positive. Therefore, the RERA can at best, probably it's trying to figure out how to get the stalemate off. Or it may be that only a few of you are actual buyers, many of the units are with the developer, and that whole process is not going through. Maybe one of the things that you can do is form yourself into a group and go as a group instead of an individual. If that is also not heeded, you can always write to the central government, because that's, in the case of a dispute between the RERA and the buyers, you can write back to the central government, which is where it is a central act. The state acts are subservient to the central act.
Yeah.
So you can go to the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and you can put your complaint there and see whether this can be addressed. Otherwise, if you feel that there is no money in the system and it cannot, therefore that project cannot be completed, you can file a complaint to the NCLT, the National Company Law Tribunal. So there are many options. Don't lose heart. I think there are many options for you to pursue. There is Rajiv Gupta of Delhi who says, can RERA judgments be implemented against the government authorities?
No.
No. RERA does not have, government authorities do not report to RERA. However, what we have noticed is wherever a RERA authority has gone to the government department, after all, there are two parallel government departments, right? And when they have gone to the government departments, in most cases, the issues have been resolved. And not because they have jurisdiction over it, but if it is a question of some procedural delays and so on, the government departments do try to resolve this. There is Mohit Verma of Pune who says, don't you think that RERA judgments should also mention timelines within which builders need to implement or provide facilities? Prabhakar, that's an interesting question, and maybe you'd like to address.
Yeah, normally they say that within certain period of time they'll have to pay. In fact, in that order itself they mention it, that before such and such date, you must refund the money, or before such and such date, you should start the construction of the project. And then after, the timeline is also mentioned that. And that timeline is basically given by the developer itself, that by when that entire project will be completed, and that authority basically include those timelines with certain modification in their order, or exactly the same timeline can also be mentioned in that order. So they give it. Now, only issue is this, that whether if that order is not implemented within the timeline, you can go back to the RERA and ask them that order has not been implemented. Now, if the order has to be looked into again or relooked, then certainly the authority RERA will look into that or pass order accordingly. So, I don't think that, I mean, look, that is everywhere. Now, you can't say in India or anywhere that if you find a certain date is given and if the order is not implemented by that day, I mean, they can just hang that developer or that party. That is not possible. So you'll have to also wait. You'll have to find out that how that resolution can be arrived at. And process is there, but certainly it is time consuming.
There is Sonia Kaur of Chandigarh who says, where can we appeal RERA orders, and is it sensible to challenge the RERA order?
Obviously. All the orders in the country can be challenged.
After all, it's your money.
Yeah, and only in the, I mean, up to Supreme Court. So the RERA order can be challenged in the in the tribunal itself. The RERA has a tribunal also, go to the tribunal. And if the tribunal, suppose the tribunal order is also not in your favor and you think that this is not justified order, you go to the High Court. And if the High Court order also think that is not justifiable, you go to the Supreme Court also. The Supreme Court order is the final.
There's Deepa Verma of Delhi who says, what is the jurisdiction of RERA in case of a district? We haven't. Actually, the RERA Act determines that, it says that there should be district RERA forums. Today, two states have given two RERA authorities. One is Haryana, where rest of Haryana and Gurgaon has become a separate RERA authority under the Haryana RERA. And in Maharashtra, Pune has a separate court. There's rest of Maharashtra and there's Pune. Eventually, there should be RERA at every district level so that you don't have to travel very far to a RERA court. But that is still in the future. I think that's really sorting out the basics at this point of time.
Yeah, and the, basically the number of projects which are under construction in various districts or that the district level are not so many, that a separate RERA bench is required there. So like in UP also, there is a RERA bench in Greater Noida, and that's look into that entire matter, and even that Lucknow one also. And the Lucknow, I believe there will be a tribunal. So this is the way, but I believe that like Noida, Greater Noida, Yamuna Expressway, Ghaziabad, this is the hub of construction activities in UP. And so the
across the country, actually 50% of the real estate activity in the country is happening in the Delhi NCR.
Delhi NCR.
So you do see a lot more problems here, but you also know that this is the largest bank of urban housing that is being built.
Yeah, exactly. And so the Gurgaon, they have also made a bench in Gurgaon also. So this is basically to address that problem. Now separate, now say in the Raibareli, there should be a RERA bench. Now, how many construction are happening there, which, where developers are selling to the private party or the private individual. So, there are not many developers or that kind of development is happening.
That doesn't mean that your complaint is not valid.
Yeah.
Your complaint is valid, and that's why the state RERA authority takes care of that.
Yeah.
It may be, today things have gone online and you will see that the online facility allows you to not keep coming to the headquarters. But if you have to, today it's early days for RERA yet, and this law requires you to come to the RERA.
Like in Maharashtra, now there should be in Nagpur also or some other state also, because there are a lot of construction are happening. And I think that the state government must be thinking on that line, that to create a bench in those cities also. So, and otherwise, I mean, as the law provides that they can, there should be at the district level.
There's Dhaval Thakkar who's written, my agreement date was June 19, but the builder has proposed December 20 as revised completion date on RERA website. What can I do?
Prabhakar,
you must explain to them why this delayed
completion. Basically what had happened that RERA came in May 2017, and at that time the government and the RERA Act itself had given in one time exemption to all the developer, that if they want to, these are the ongoing projects launched somewhere around 2015 or 16 or 2014. Some projects have been launched in 2005-06 that are still under construction. To all these projects, the authority said that you give me a new timeline by which the project should be completed. Because right now, if a developer is not able to complete a project on certain the given deadline, then what happens that they'll have to pay a penal interest rate, and that penal interest rate is as per the agreement is 5 rupees per square feet per month kind of a rental they have to pay. So until the possession is given, this is the kind of damages they have to pay. Now under the RERA Act, if the delay happens, then they'll have to pay at SBI's MCLR rate plus 2 percentage point, which comes out to be somewhere around 10% or 10.25% today. So at that rate, at that interest rate, the developer has to pay money to the buyers. Now that rate is very high, let me tell you. And so what happens that now developer authority said that, okay, you give me a new timeline, and by that timeline
you will be penalized if you exceed that timeline.
Timeline with the new rate. And with the earlier kind of a rate that you have mentioned in your agreement till the old timeline. So this is the kind of a thing they have worked out. But the new timeline was given because they had not adhered to the old timeline. So now if they have to be completed, they have to give a timeline that by when they will be completed. So this new date that they have given you, the 2020, is the new timeline by which they will have to complete the project. And if not, then they will come under RERA and RERA will penalize them.
Vineet Kumar is asking, what is the position of RERA in case of redevelopment policies? Places like L Zone or Jaivar, how will RERA come into play?
Everywhere, there is a new construction, so it will come under RERA. Before starting construction or before starting selling that project in the market, they'll have to take all the approvals. And only getting all the approvals, they will launch the project, and only after launching the project, they can sell in the market. And not only that, they will have to mention all the entire timeline that by when the project will be completed. Before getting the register the project with the RERA, they will have to say close that entire financial closure, that how they will manage the finance. Which are giving them the loan to complete the projects, and how much money they are expecting from the buyer side to come to complete the project. After getting all the financial closure only, the project will be registered. After registering the project, they will start selling it. Now, after selling it, whatever money you will pay, 70% of that money will go into the escrow account, which will be used to complete the projects. And the timeline which they have given, they have to adhere to, and that timeline, mind it sir, that it is quarterly. Every quarter they will have to say that what progress in the construction has to be made, and the RERA do monitor that how the progress is happening. And if suppose in a particular quarter they lag behind, then in the next quarter they will have to make it.
They can't take money out of the escrow account. The money that is your money that goes into the escrow account can only be taken out when the project has it is construction linked. So when a project has fallen behind, they don't have access to the money. Why would any developer delay a project deliberately knowing that there is money in the system but I can't take it out? So RERA has sorted out your future. Any development, any sale that happens in the market will be covered by RERA.
Secured. So now the new projects, I believe the way the RERA has to monitor it, not that RERA is monitoring, but RERA has to monitor it under the Act, the delay should not happen now. That is for sure.
And the safeguards are there within the system.
Yeah.
There is Gaurav Singh of Navi Mumbai. Says that in case of a wrong detail in the RERA judgment, can you get it corrected at RERA office?
Obviously.
I want to get it corrected in Maharashtra. Please suggest. Of course.
Of
RERA
course.
Is not a authoritarian do or die kind of authority. They are very, very friendly to consumers. They understand that you are coming in not as legal claimants and all that, but as ordinary everyday buyers who wanted to buy a house for self-use. So you are not conversant with the law, and they don't treat you like lawyer saying that this was wrong or that was wrong. They do accommodate all your requests. They understand that you are everyday people who don't have legal knowledge. But you have come there to find resolution, and RERA is very, very aware of that.
And inadvertent discrepancy that crops in into a judgment is corrected by all the courts, whether it is Supreme Court or High Court, all the courts. And this kind of a mistakes happens, and I have seen even in the Supreme Court judgment this kind of a mistakes appearing.
Right. And you can get it corrected.
Yeah.
There is no harm in saying that this was a mistake, I want it corrected.
It happens and they correct it.
There is Deepak Singh who says, a friend of mine got refund order by RERA, but the builder says to me that he will give refund in part payment. Shall he go by the builder's words or again go to RERA?
Again go to RERA,
and even if it is part payments that the builder is offering, it has to be registered under RERA that you have given me an order for full payment. But however, today considering my money situation, I will give you in part payments. But of course, it has to be registered under RERA that this is the agreement between you and the developer. Once you have gone to RERA, please make sure that you keep RERA in the loop for any changes to that order or agreements that you're making privately with the developer. Because ultimately, if you want justice, till the project gets completed, that project is under the jurisdiction of RERA. And RERA will get you your justice. Just want to make sure that you understand why we are picking up this issue at this point of time. That is because the Central Act provisions determine that within 2 years of the RERA Act coming, which is May 1st, 2017, till May 1st, 2019, whatever provisions of the law that it's a new act, there may be provisions which are not in...
Up to the mark.
Yeah, up to the mark. And to correct all those provisions, the central government has time till the 1st of May 2019. That's a very, very short time. And the government has talked to every RERA authority to figure out what are the problems they have faced in dealing with the problems in their states. Basis this, a central document is being created. It is also working with the law ministry to figure out how these changes can be made. And that is why there is so much emphasis on what is not working today and how it can be made to work.
And various authorities are giving feedback to the central authority to do it.
Okay. And I think that this is the time that we are going to give you the results of our poll. 50% of consumers said yes and 50% said no to our poll result, which means that we have a completely divided house. But I think please continue to take this poll. Please continue to be invested.
But this clearly suggests that the RERA law has to be further strengthened. Yes. And the government must work towards that.
Consumers are not satisfied that RERA, the RERA rules, the judgments are being implemented well. But the fact is that there is an authority that you can go to, which was not there 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And the first year, there was a lot of understanding of the law by the RERA regulators themselves, setting up the processes, setting up the regulators, figuring out how to issue the judgments. But today we feel that the RERA regulators are a very confident lot, and they are able to figure out that there are problems and go through to how these can go through to resolution. But long way to go, new act, promising act. Keep watching This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup and this is Prabhakar Sinha.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please subscribe to Magicbricks on YouTube and click the bell icon to get new videos.